Hello friends, welcome to Dreamweaver Crocheting with Love. In today's tutorial, we are going to learn a stitch called balloon stitch. This is a very easy and a pretty stitch. Now, two things to be noted while working this stitch is that one is the number of stitches that we work as a space between the two balloons should be always odd in number. Now, I'll say you the reason for that once we start doing with this stitch. And the second thing to be noted is while working a balloon stitch, you should always work on the wrong side of your crochet work, because when you work the stitch on the wrong side, the balloons will get formed on the right side. So this is the right side of our crochet pattern, while this is the wrong side. So as we work through the pattern, it will become more clear to you. So let's begin. Now for this sample, I have chained 23. So that would be a multiple of 6 plus 5 stitches. Over here, we have worked these balloons with a spacing of 3 stitches between each of them. But in this sample piece that I am going to work right now, I will be giving a spacing of 5 stitches between each of the balloons. So let's see how this is worked. First, I need to chain 1 and turn my work. Now, in the first 5 stitches, I will be working 1 single crochet each. Into the 6th stitch, I will be working a balloon. For that, I need to yarn over, insert my hook into the stitch and pull up a loop and go through 2 loops. Again, yarn over, insert, pull a loop, go through 2 loops. Again, yarn over, insert, pull a loop, go through 2 loops. So, I need to continue doing this until I have 7 loops on my hook. Till now, I have 4 loops. So, I'll be repeating this till I have 7 loops on my hook. So, now you can see I have 7 loops on my hook. I need to yarn over and pull through all the 7 loops. So that finishes our balloon. As you can see, this is quite flat from the front part. Now in order to bulge it from the front, we will be working a single crochet into the immediate stitch. So that will give this bulgy appearance. So since I am working on the wrong side of my crochet work, the balloon is getting formed on the right side. Now again, I need to work single crochets. So I have already worked my first single crochet. Since I had mentioned that I will be providing a spacing of 5 single crochets, so I need to work 4 more. So this is my 5th single crochet. Into the 6th stitch, again I will be working a balloon. For that, I need to repeat the process. Yarn over, insert, pull a loop, go through 2 loops. Again yarn over, insert, go through 2 loops. So just continue till you have 7 loops on your hook. So in total you'll be working like this for 6 times. So here I have 7 loops on my hook. I need to go through all the 7 loops and work a single crochet into the next stitch. I need to work 4 more. So in the 6th stitch, I'll be working a balloon. So I hope this is very clear to you by now. It's very easy to do. So I'll be ending this with 5 single crochets. Working my last single crochet on the top of 3rd. So that finishes our balloon stitch row. So you can see how lovely this balloon stitch appears on the front part. Now the second row would be working simple double crochet stitches on top of this. So while working the right side of the crochet pattern, I need to chain 1 and work 1 double crochet on top of each of the stitches. So on top of 5 single crochets, I'll be working 1 double crochet each. And on top of this bubble stitch, I need to work 1 double crochet. So you should see to that you do not skip any of the stitches. The count of the stitches should remain the same at end of each of the rows. Now since I worked 23 double crochet initially, by end of this row I should have 23 double crochets. I'll show you how to work a double crochet on top of the balloon stitch. For that, you'll be having this stitch on top of the balloon stitch. You have to just go through it and work a double crochet on top of it. And just continue working like this till the end of the row. So here I worked my third row with simple double crochets. Now in order to work the fourth row, that will be the row of balloon stitches, I need to chain one and turn my work. Now I'll be working single crochets into first two stitches. Followed by one balloon stitch into my third stitch. So the sequence is same as I done before. I'll be working 5 single crochets into next 5 stitches. Again, I'll be working a balloon into my 6th stitch. So you just continue the pattern of working like this. Work 5 single crochets followed by a balloon stitch till the end of the row. So here I have finished with my fourth row of balloon stitches. Now as I mentioned before, the spacing that we provide between each of the balloon stitches should be odd numbered. The reason for that is when you work the second row of balloon stitches, you will have your balloon stitches in between the balloon stitches of previous row. So that will give you a very nice pattern. So you should see to that you always have odd number of stitches between the balloons, so that the next row of balloon stitches can be placed in between the previous row of balloon stitches. So as mentioned before, the next row would be a row of simple double crochets. So for that, again I need to chain one and turn my work. I'll be working 2 double crochets on top of the 2 single crochets worked, and 1 double crochet on top of the balloon stitch. Again I'll be working 5 double crochets on top of 5 single crochets that I've worked. So you have to just continue like this. So here I've done with my 5th row of double crochets. So this stitch pattern is basically a repeat of 4 rows, that is 1 row of double crochets followed by 1 row of bubble stitches, again a double crochet and 1 row of bubble stitches. So this 4 rows you have to repeat multiple number of times depending upon the crochet work that you are doing. So this stitch pattern you can use for doing various baby crochet work, like baby bonnets or baby blankets, cardigans, and it will give a lovely appearance to your crochet work. So I hope this tutorial was useful for you. If you have any queries, please let me know through comments. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.